Yeah, my novel is about, well, love. That was what I set out to write about. Love in a very special sense. This first, the infatuation phase of love. And my main character, Esther Nilsson, falls very suddenly in love with Hugo Rask, who's an artist, and she's a poet and philosopher and essayist. And I wanted to explore this theme of two people who really cannot communicate at all around this subject that they are intensely engaged in, although he is not that intensely engaged, but she is. This is a novel about Esther Nilsson, the woman who pursues this love and happiness that she knows thinks she would find with him, and everything looks good, but it's not what she thinks, and he's not at all into it in the same way that she is. Well, when you set out to write a story about love, you have quite a history and tradition to be compared with and to take into consideration. It's a really explored subject. Many people, many writers, filmmakers, artists have been there trying to add something to this subject. So what could I add, I thought? Well, I wanted to not just describe it, but also in a way to try to explain some parts of what happens with the feelings. I mean, to add both feelings and reason, which is what Esther does. She is really much a mixture of emotions and analysis of these emotions, and her capacity to analyze things doesn't help her at all. Maybe the opposite. But I wanted really to verbalize, to put into words what is going on in her and between them, and what happens when this happens, that happens in the book. We don't learn, and that's my whole point. I wanted to show Esther's patterns, and that's why I wrote another book about her that came out in Sweden in 2014, a year after Esther, Ola Passion Pure. Because, and then she makes the same mistake again. Although it's not really a mistake, because what happens to her is, it's part of life, and it's an interesting experience, and you can't just live your life without experiencing pain. And she would rather have pain than boredom. So she consciously goes, she chooses a path where that's risky, emotionally risky. And that's a conscious decision that she makes. So she acts on impulse. But at the same time, she watches herself and analyzes what's going on. Maybe they are archetypes. I wouldn't say Esther is an archetype, but she might become one in a way. We might discover that this is an archetype that we didn't think was an archetype, because she's not typically... she's not in accordance with the gender role when she acts like this. She's too, aggressive in her pursuit to be a typical woman. A woman is not supposed to pursue like this, to hunt. And she doesn't really understand the gender roles. She thinks they are medieval, old-fashioned, that things that we left behind long time ago. We are modern people. But yes, I think she's in a way archetype. I mean, this painful longing for something and trying to get it. Hugo Rask, well, he's a typical narcissist. He loves maybe nobody and not even himself. But he knows how to go through the motions of love. And he has a definite problem with intimacy, but not with sex, because sex is not intimate. Intimacy is when someone expects something from you. Intimacy is when Esther thinks that now they're together and she can expect him to call her and that they meet again tomorrow and that they want to meet again tomorrow. That's the intimacy that he just can't stand or accept. I just wanted to write this book about love that I had tried to write for a decade without really having the courage or whatever it takes. And then finally I got around to writing it, and it came out, and I hope maybe for 2,000 readers in Sweden, and it just exploded. Something happened, and so many people recognized themselves in, especially in Esther, and those who recognized themselves in Hugo maybe didn't say it. The word of mouth started going around, and people just started buying it and reading it and discussing it. And I've met librarians and booksellers in many of them in Sweden who say, I have to discuss this every day with my clients or the borrowers or the customers. We discuss Esther Nilsson all day long here. It turned out that many people had done the same things that Esther does, or thought the same things, felt the same things, but it's something that they're embarrassed about. So she's like a relief for people. Oh, someone else did this. I'm not a strange person.